6, verse 39. Chapter 6, verse 39, 40. How he resisted temptation because he had the Holy Spirit in him. because he was 100% man and 100% God. The word of God, you see it. No, the word of word is many people, when they say, they call it like the story, like, you know, in the Bible. Some people call it the word, some call it a story, you know, like the story. But, you know, I always call it, you know, the word. It always seems to say, but you see me always say the word of God instead of a story and stuff. But we're studying on Luke chapter 1 and 2. And now we're going to study on chapter 6. And we're going to try to focus on Jesus Christ. We're trying to look at the main thing. And yeah, you can. I was tempted to talk about some other topic, but I'm going to preach that Wednesday. I decided to preach this right now. And the goal is to try to focus on Jesus Christ. You know, we speak every day, and you know, I went up to a group of boys, and I decided, you know, mouth words and stuff, and everyone, all the boys know, whenever he always does that, but then a human boy is just confused, and then he's crazy. You know, because there's no words coming out. Just, you know, it looked weird. I didn't make any sound. I just mouthed stuff. Maybe I made a little bit sound. I'm not sure. I'm deaf. But it's funny because I was joking around with David Rayless. I said, "You mouthing and all that." And David Rayless laughed so hard because he could hear some voice out of it. But the word. I can't speak, but I can sign, so it's when some hearing people always look down to deaf people and think, you know, they're not really talking that much. It's, you know, they're dumb and stuff. But I'm sorry, some hearing people are like that. Some hearing people just think low of deaf people. But it's very interesting. God himself started, you know, when he spoke to create the everything. He said, let there be light, and there it was. Who invented God? God, who invented the word? Or, you know, to speak? God did. And it's sad because I watch TV and I talk to some of my friends and they don't start cursing, and you know, and who invented pure words? God did, and we people, the world likes to abuse the words, and our goal should be to try to speak purely on the God all the time. Yeah. Try not to be offensive, or you know, there's many different types of ways you can talk. You can fool around, you know. You can start judging people, and it's. I think ASL is very interesting. There's some people that are not so good at it. They like to sign in like all in English, but some people are really skilled with ASL, and it's really good. I'm not like that. I'm some other people that I'd gift them, they're really good at signing at ASL, and some people abuse that whenever they're really good at ASL. Enough of that, we're going to focus on the Word of God, the Bible. Now, this is life. This is living. It's active. The Bible is active and living. That right there. And sit down after my friend about football or anything like sports. What is sports? It's not living, it's not active. It's 10 years later, you might forget 95% of the conversation, you're going to forget it with sports. But with the Bible, it continues forever. Clearly, it says in it says in the Bible that it will not fade away. We should be careful with the Bible, and we should honor it. And it says in the Bible, the word was God, and it's pointing towards Jesus Christ. Now, I'm gonna focus on a verse. And Jesus tells a story about the blind. Can a blind man lead another blind man? And it's it's very ironic, because it's like, you know, some people have like holding a stick when a blind person holds a certain kind of stick, like something to help them. Like sometimes there's a dog that helps. There's some people that depend on a dog. I mean, some deaf people depend on the dogs to hear. I don't think it's necessary, but some deaf people think it's necessary. I mean, we don't do that, but that's okay. It's their business. But with blind people, yeah, I think yes, because you know, something can hit a blind person. The dog, when the dog sees. Yeah, supposedly, if a blind person has one dog, you can't do that. You want to know where you go, the dog can't protect you. It can't leave you in the right place. It would depend on its hearing, and yeah, it just can't happen. And a blind person can't lead a blind person. They're going to know. They will for sure fall into a pit. Now, making fun of blind people, is this making fun of blind people? No, it isn't, because it's just saying that blind people need help, and they need, just like, sometimes we need help as deaf people. We need some device to let us know that there's someone at the door. Now, why does it happen? Why is deaf and blind here? And the reason why is of the fall, because of sin. And that's why we have that problem. And some people think, some deaf people are very prideful and think that's not the reason. But honestly, it means deaf means that, you know, your ear does not work. As simple as that. You can't be prideful about being deaf. I mean, obviously it's because of sin. You know, whether you're blind or deaf, you're normal. Like some people call themselves normal. No one's normal, period. Honestly. Deaf people and hearing, they're both. No one's normal. Everyone needs Jesus. All of us need Jesus. Now, with that verse, blind person leading another blind person, what does that really mean? Now, you have to read the context and you'll understand. It could be a pastor, it could be a leader, it could be a teacher, but he could be teaching something else and everyone start believing him. For sure. Suppose I was a deaf pastor. I was a false pastor, and I said false things. Where I'm gonna go to hell. But also, the people that believed me would go to hell as well, I think. But they were innocent. No one's innocent. Everyone's guilty of sin. But now I'm gonna say something about Mormonism. I suppose someone goes to that church, goes to a false teaching, and he's like, the pastor's terrible and, you know, it's false teaching, but it also includes the church as well. The people in the church are also going to hell. If a blind person needs another blind person, it's the cause that they're going to fall in the pit. And that's what the verse means. You have to be very careful. I'm not perfect. Lord, help me out. On purpose, I want to be telling the truth all the time. My goal is to be truthful at all times. But sometimes I look at other pastors, a different pastor, and sometimes they say something different about the verse. They interpret the wrong way. I don't know if they're blind or they don't really understand, but they think they're right, and they just put away the Bible, and then, you know, they say it's old, it's outdated, they put it away. Now, some pastors think, yeah, there's a pastor who calls himself a Christian, and he's well known. Oh wait, no, it's a person, it's a deaf person. He says he's a Christian. He calls himself a Christian. He's very popular in the deaf community. And he puts away the Bible. He says it's outdated, and, you know, and he accepts homosexual. He respects everyone. And he's blind. That's the thing. And many deaf people love him, but really he's blind. He's just leading everyone to hell. He's giving you, he's teaching him, it's called teaching him false stuff. Now, can a blind person lead a blind person? They will fall in the pit. And I suppose you say, oh, well, the blind person was prideful and he thought he knew what he was doing. But the other blind people that were following a blind person is innocent, and they are fine. They can go to heaven. Now, but the Bible says that both of them go to hell. So I was very shocked about this. One pastor asked me a question, and I couldn't answer it. It's too hard. He said one girl told him, ask a pastor. He said, he's talking to a, I love this guy, he's a godly man, but this woman asked the pastor, you're reformed, you're Calvinist, but this person isn't. This Bible, it says clearly, yes, why can't this person see it? There's a verse that clearly says, says it, and then the pastor asked me, and, you know, I struggle with it too. Some people don't believe a certain thing in the Bible, and it clearly says in the Bible that it's true, and they just refuse to believe it. And I try to explain all this thing, but sometimes people just go into denial. They say, oh, someone else said something else. I always think, I always say, explain me what this means. And they refuse to. But, he serves the Lord, and he's, you know, involved with the church. He's great. He's a great person. But he just refused to believe that one certain passage. I'm not going to judge him. You're not going to say he's going to hell. I can't do that. It's not my business. I'm just going to tell the truth. That's all I'm going to do. I'm not going to say he's going to hell. I'm not going to say, I'm not going to judge everyone. I'm not going to say who goes to heaven or who goes to hell. But I'm just curious. Is he blind, or does he understand a little bit. I can't answer that. You asking me if he's going to heaven or hell, I don't know. I look at him. He has good faith. Now, there's three different things I heard preach something. Something about holiness, scripture holiness, and then the second thing, or the third thing. That was like three different types. The first one is like kind of like the Presbyterian Reform. It's like their kind of type. They believe in the Bible, but then the traditional. We accept some of it as Reformed, but as long as it doesn't contradict the Bible. Like, how do we do stuff? Like, we usually, say the Ten Commandments and the Apostles' Creed and all that. We don't see any contradiction. Some people say, no, we should take away the Apostles' Creed and take away the Ten Commandments and just have singing and preaching. I see some Reformed people who do that, that take away that have the offering in the back of the room, and instead of having someone bring it around. We don't say that's wrong, that's their kind of way. I like to go through the whole thing. There's no contradiction. That's fine, I accept that, but That's how it is in the second one. It's just like the independent Baptist people, they think. They would think KJV only. And they think, they're very, they're not very open to any other things. Like, if you try to explain something to them, they won't believe. They say most of the stuff you have to follow most of the stuff with the Old Testament, but also, and then also the third, that seems like kind of pointing out the Catholics, like they think, like it's like a tradition, and they don't, sometimes there's like contradiction, they continue going. The Reforms, they decide not to, they didn't agree with the Catholics. Because there's a lot of contradiction with what they were doing. We disagree with it, but the Word of God, very important. It's our protector. Someone tells us something, we can apply it, we can use the Bible and apply it. And Jesus warned us about this. Blind man leading another blind man. And now we're going to go down. Why do your brother pick on the little peck on your eye when he has a big log? When he has a big log in his eyes, how can you say, brother, let me get rid of that little peck on your eye, when he himself has a ginormous log on his eye? Like, it's pretty much telling, like, it's pretty much being a hypocrite. That's what the verse says. It's kind of funny to think about it. I don't know why you would think it's funny. It's someone with a ginormous log on his eye. You know? Just like on his eye. And he's still trying to peck on someone else's. Whenever he has like a small little peck of wood. You know, it just doesn't make any sense. You know, someone, he's getting that having to induce to think, well, you have a humongous frog on your eyes, so you're just being a hypocrite. And, you know, first take off the log in your eye, then you can see it's permitted. If you take off the log in your eye, you can see clearly and you can pick. Some people abuse, like, you can't judge and all that. But it says you can understand. You have to change. You can't be a hypocrite. You can't tell someone to do something when you do it. And I meet many, many people, many Christians, they're self-righteous, that pick on me. And they pick on me with a couple of stuff, I think. But you have a large log in your eye. But I think, but there's many people that do that. That are being hypocrites, that tell people to do something, that tell people that they're doing something wrong when they're doing it as well. Now, I just want to tell you guys just to watch yourself, watch your heart. One person, a video called, and he told me that you preach about reading the Bible all the time. What if the person couldn't read? And yeah, that's a good question. What if someone couldn't read? Now, I know you guys, and you guys can read. If you say you can't read, you're not that good as of a reader, I say bogus. I'm talking about people that can't read, like literally can't read. And I told the person, do you know someone that can't read? Go ahead and, you know, say it to them. Go ahead and read it to them. You know, some people pretend they can't read because they don't want to read the Bible. God knows everyone. God knows everyone's heart. And if he wanted to, he will take someone to help someone that can't read. He will do that. Now, people might think, oh, he's innocent because he can't read. But he's still guilty for his own sins. And I preached a couple of weeks ago about one little white lie, you'd still go to hell. Like, this is saying, like, if Jesus never said it, if we sin just one little white lie, we'd go to hell. We'd have to be perfect to go to hell. Now, this is funny. Suppose you get something from the sewer, you get one little drop of something from the sewer, you put it into a really clean water. Would you still drink it? No, you say no. Like one little small drip of something from the sewer. And then in a cup of clean water. Some people think, no, I'd never do that. People think, oh, it's just a small little drop. See, that's just like with the real life, whenever you sin, a little bit sin. God will say no. It's just like with that. You put a little drop of water from the sewer. You know, tap water, so there's many chemicals in it. You might think that's super dirty, but also with Jesus, God does not accept any sins. Anyone that is not perfect. Like, you have to be perfect to go to heaven, and the only way you can do that is through Jesus. It's not through anyone. It's not through me. It's not through the church. It's only through Jesus Christ. Picking on someone, even though you do the exact same thing, even though you had a big one, right? You have to be very careful. It's amazing how the Lord God teaches us when that God gave us the Bible and it's pure, and many times people will pick out one little verse out of the Bible and show it to someone. You really have to look at the context. You have to be very careful with the Bible. You can't just pick up one little verse and use it. Look through the context, because there might be a different meaning to it. So, something else about, you know, being a hypocrite or blind man leading a blind man. This right here is less. A good tree does not make bad fruit. In other words, a bad tree will not make good fruit. Clearly, it says it here. Everyone you meet up with someone, and supposedly you're a Christian, and you talk to him, he likes to curse, and he likes to say stuff. He's a Christian. He says he's a Christian. He thinks all about that stuff. You think that's good fruit? No, it's bad fruit. Clearly. Now, this fruit is awful. Just like some other Christians, they're always talking about money. He's always greedy. He's always pride. He's Christian. He always thinks about money. Now, and also someone else that thinks all about sports, football, basketball, and, you know, ask anything else, no, always think about sports. See, it's interesting to look at other people, and some people can, it's great when people ask if there's any problems with them, like if they don't show fruit. Now, if you keep thinking that, you know, everyone's hearts are evil, if you keep thinking sports all the time, your heart is obviously evil. You always think about your house, always your neat freak, you have to have it clean, you know, your heart's evil. Or you think all about the church, your heart can be evil. You know, church doesn't say that you have to keep thinking about Jesus Christ. He is the Lord and Savior. Let's think about the Jesus Christ one. Because he came to save us and his good word. Not the church. The church and the building, the thing. All that. We need to look up to Christ instead of just the church. Now, how does, whenever you talk to a person, sometimes I'll confront the person, he get really upset, he gets so mad, and it really just proves the point. You can tell whenever you mess with their things or something they love, you can tell it might be their idol, it could be their God. If they start insulting God, and they start insulting everyone. See, some people like to tell me that people always talk bad about me, and I think, you know, I feel bad about it sometimes, but I can't stop that. So I'm human. I'm terrible. That's fine. Keep thinking that I'm a terrible person, but you saw Jesus Christ. You offend Jesus Christ. I'm upset. He deserves everyone's respect. I don't earn anyone's respect. Everyone should respect Jesus. That's the only thing I care. See, there's a blind man leading a blind man. There's hypocrite, and there's evil. Yeah. the Word of God. Where are you now? You must read it. You must understand also what's going to be in your heart. You have to know a lot about the Bible. You don't have it in your heart. If you know everything about the Bible and you like to judge everyone, you'll have a big log in your eye because you don't have it in your heart. You have to have it in your heart as well. You must think, you know, you can help everyone. And yeah, so some people believe you must do good. You must do really good. And then you'll be saved. That's not how it works. The Bible must go in your heart. And then you do good works. Suppose you do good works, and then you have it in your heart. That's some good work is not gonna get you into heaven. Only if you truly have it in your heart. Only if you truly have Jesus saved. Now, some people will. Now, it's just all about the grace of God. It's not because of my good works, my preaching, my witnessing, how I read the Bible, how I pray. None of that. I go to heaven because of His grace. That's all. Some people think, oh wait, you did so many good things. God doesn't count all my good actions. He only counts Jesus Christ and what He did. God only counts that right there. And Jesus Christ saved us all. Because of that. Because of Jesus' work. Not because of my actions. I'm going to heaven. Now, some people think, oh, you're very lucky. You're going to heaven. For sure, and because you're a pastor, I'm thinking, no, it's not because I'm a pastor, it's because Jesus Christ saved me. I'm only going, how you learn about all this stuff and you read the Bible. Now, Jesus was straightforward about this. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and you don't do what I say? You don't do anything that I say. When I tell you, do all that stuff. Hold up. You call me Lord. If you don't follow Jesus, then you always say Lord, Lord. You always say you do, like pretty much saying you're a Christian when you really are. 95% of Christians will say they're just Christians, but they won't do what God tells them to. They don't do what Jesus said. There's many Christians that profess to be Christian. Now, I love how Shane said, a lot of people say, what would Jesus do? And now, it's a big thing. Everyone has like a necklace or a bracelet. Throw that away. What would Jesus do? Jesus already did. He's in life. What is Jesus doing now? He's celebrating. And people think, what would Jesus do? No, He already did. For me. We thank Him. Please, if the Holy Spirit is in your heart, you will follow what Jesus says. You think, Lord, Lord, what would you do? Should I do this or that? What would you do? Don't ever think that. What He says you do it. That's it. You don't ask, what would you do? Struggling sin. I really like this. And I really like this. Do not feel your feelings. Do not follow your feelings. don't care what you feel like, honestly. Because many times I feel like doing something and it's rebelling. It's not following. Follow what the Lord says, that's good. That's what we should do. Instead of following what you feel, don't rely on your feelings. Your feelings will deceive you many times. Follow the Lord. Now, you know the story about the wise man and the foolish man. And the wise man would make a foundation, make a building, and follow what he says. When it starts wind, when it starts storming, the house would stand. The building would stand and it won't fall over. And the foolish man, he hears about Jesus Christ and believes it, but he doesn't do anything. His building is going to be terrible, and it's not a foundation. It'll be destroyed. It won't be like kind of destroyed, it'll be destroyed. That storm will destroy it, like it would be destroyed clean. And then sometimes you see on TV, you see like what the tornado done, and it destroys like everything, just like that. Destroy the house. If you do not obey, if you do not follow up with the word, destroy your foundation, your house will just be destroyed. But if you obey and you build your foundation just right, you'll be just fine because you have the Bible in your heart. And now, so blind, I opened up with a blind. Doesn't have the Bible in his heart and preaches false things, and people come to him. And then also judging other people whenever you are doing the same thing. You know, picking on someone that has something little in his eye when you have a big one. Also, the third thing, thinking about evil stuff, like being very prideful, thinking you're better than everyone else, and number four, something messed up, if you're foolish, you're going to be destroyed. Four things you follow, open up your eyes instead of being blind and leading people. And number two, be truthful. Don't pick on someone when you have a huge log in your eye. Instead, tell them, even though you're sinning, still tell them. Like, follow the Bible and be truthful about yourself. Don't think you're perfect. Number three, be good. Have always try to be. I mean, God is graceful. And, just try to be fruitful. And number four, be wise. And have a foundation. And see those four. See those eight. The four on the left are all based on God and what the Bible says. And the other four is just their own. Their own thoughts, man's own thoughts and flesh. And the people that follow God's word, that's the right way to think. Jesus Christ is the word, praise the Lord. I pray that you will think about it. You just have to be very nice. If I see some stranger and he talks about divorce and stuff, and like, and I think I let them know. You're a Christian and you're sleeping with someone for marriage. I let them know. My flesh would say, no, just forget. But the Word of God says, and I have to tell you. I know it might hurt you, you might be offended. And the man's like, man says, okay, thank you for telling the truth. Some pastors won't say anything. They'll just ignore it. The pastors will like respect them and say, it's fine. But I told them the truth. I told them, sleep in separate rooms right now. Right now. I would say, no, just take it slow, but I can't do that. But the Bible says, now. You know, God is strict, and you best to obey it. And the person was happy about it. I could say it's fine, but I'm going to follow the Lord. I'm going to tell you that this, you can't do it. Now, I always have like battles with my flesh inside. I was talking to the phone. I was talking to my wife. I asked, do I have a strong foundation? And my wife says, yeah, you have a strong foundation. You can stand by your word. And I realized, oh, that's why people hate me. No. I try to be truthful. I try my best to be truthful. Sometimes I make mistakes. I can be wrong. I'm not right all the times. I'm a sinner. My goal is to try to be right at all times, like, try to be truthful with everything I say. Sometimes you have a different view with what I have. Praise the Lord, and I pray that and the only way to heaven is through Jesus, not through me, it's not through the church. It's not through your good works, just through Jesus Christ. Sometimes I sin against you, and help me to be truthful, to speak nice, and praise your name, Lord. I pray that the church, everyone in the church will think about this to apply, and I will think about you and what you did. And I pray that everyone will be blind. No one will be a hypocrite. No one will be evil. No one will be fooled. I pray that everyone in this church will be able to sin, and that they will know the truth. That they will know that we're all sinners. And we only have to depend upon you. The truth. That we will be fruitful as well. That we will have Jesus. And that we'll have a strong foundation. And work hard on it. And not have the easy life. Lord, be with us. Help us. Thank you.